Joining me for the first time here at Proactive Australia is Fireweed Metals CEO Brandon MacDonald. Brandon, so lovely to have you in the studio with us today. You're joining us live from the IMARC conference in Sydney. How's it been so far?
It's been pretty good. It's a pretty big show, so it's nice to make it out. I've had a pretty busy slate of meetings and lots of good, serendipitous encounters as well. So I think it's been well worth the trip.
It's really good to meet you. Obviously, you are exploring a range of critical mineral portfolios and projects over in Canada. You describe your mission as creating critical mineral prospects for generations, both current and future. Tell us a little bit more about that mission.
I think we recognize that the critical minerals that enable our modern life and not just in countries like Canada and Australia, but will enable, a more modern life in developing countries. Producing these critical minerals is not something that you just turn a button or you press a button and it doesn't just happen, right? So there are decades of exploration, development, and construction and production that go into producing these things. So we recognize a need now for them, but we also recognize that we have to plant the seeds and do the work for future generations as well. And both our assets, our flagship assets, are likely to be very long mine life. In fact, if I were to wager a guess, I suspect both will outlive me in terms of their production, right? So there's in a sense that old expression about society is great when people plant, trees under which the shade they'll never rest or however it goes, right? But the point is, we're planting those seeds.
Seems like there is certainly a really proactive approach here. Tell us a little bit about what you're seeing at IMARC at the moment. Is there a lot of that kind of future or forward thinking happening across the conference?
Yeah, I think you're seeing it in two ways. Yes, in our side of things, in terms of the exploration and development side, and in terms of the exploring and building these new projects for critical minerals. I think critical minerals is really a hot topic right now, and governments and investors are cluing into a necessity in this area. But also what's interesting is, for me, as someone who's worked his career in exploration and development, seeing the very interesting new technologies in production that are emerging. We're seeing very interesting robotics here. We're seeing very interesting, all sorts of electric vehicles for mine sites. So a big focus on future technology.
Really interesting to hear about that, considering the news that you put out this week. You're looking at some metallurgy results for your Macmillan Pass zinc project. Can you tell us a little bit about that announcement and what it means for the company?
Well, we had done metallurgy in the past on two different zones in the project. The initial two that we acquired when we launched the company, that was the Tom deposit and the Jason deposit. Since we discovered Boundary and Boundary West and established, hopefully soon, an inaugural resource at those two, we understood that it was likely to behave different metallurgically than the other deposits. So getting this metallurgy in, and this is a long time coming, thanks to COVID and related delays. This was actually a process we kicked off in 2019, believe it or not. I mean, I guess the metallurgy was kicked off in 2020, but it was done on holes that we drilled in 2019, right? So long time coming, but we absolutely like what we see. As we suspected, and as confirmed, much coarser grind in boundary zone than Tom and Jason. So it looked like it's going to be easier to liberate the economic minerals. It's going to produce a nice high-grade concentrate. So we're pretty happy, that this first, delving into metallurgy in that zone has produced great results.
As you approach the end of the year and work continues across your project portfolio, are there any news announcements that investors should be looking out for?
Well, yeah, look, I think it's a problem in Australia too, but in Canada, we're obviously waiting a long time for assays. We submitted our first batches in early August from our summer program. We are expecting the first of those results to start coming in reasonably quickly. I would, at the risk of making myself be a liar, I would predict within the next couple of weeks we might have our first results out, and those will continue to come into the new year. And those will obviously help feed into to an updated understanding of the deposits and hopefully updated resource in the coming year. On you know, both our zinc and tungsten projects should have updated resources.
Brandon, we're looking forward to hearing more about what's happening across that portfolio, and I'm sure we'll hear more across both our Australian base and also over at Proactive Canada as well. Thank you so much for your time.
Yeah, thanks for having me.